Kimba.
I grew up on concrete where I cut my teeth. There ain't no trick up my sleeve. I was pure as Eve till I showed up in this industry. I was the only one covered in leaves when I realized these niggas not like me. Fuck it, I was naive, I was fooled, I want to believe this shit was my dream. I skipped school, I underachieved, I pulled up my jeans. Me and my niggas ran from police when they told us freeze, nigga, please, nigga. Back from a city of bastards, I've been the ambassador, leading in Catholics and killings and capping per capita. My skin is brown as the liquor, the lynching, the bathwater. I may be taking my talents to Africa. Earth is gonna orbit perfectly in perfect time and circles, not to be deterred by any person. I don't see its purpose. I don't have to rhyme hyperbole in every verse. The average person has no need interpreting the meaning. Niggas know with certainty.
Why are you like this?
When I was writing 180, the first thing is kind of like figuring out the tone, which I think is like colors. Like I see the colors that Toby used to paint, and then I have to pick a color that complements it, but is also needed. You know, that works with it, but is also needed. And then it's like trying to figure out what instrument I'm a mimic. So. I grew up on concrete where I cut my teeth. There ain't no trick up my sleeve. I was pure as Eve. To me, that feels like a drum line, like Nick Cannon. And then I love to start with painting a picture, setting the scene. I just thought it was ill to think of like somebody with pure intentions coming straight from like the Garden of Eden. With no clothes on, just a leaf covering, you know, and how you put them in the modern day situation in the music industry, because you know they love music in such a pure way, and then realizing that it has nothing to do with their love. The industry has nothing to do with their love for music. Has no bearing on how successful a musician is going to be, and how shocking that is, especially when sort of like your whole life was tailor-made to that. Like even in school I was writing instead of paying attention, you know. So when you get to that moment and you think, hey, look, industry, look how dedicated I am to the music, like to music, and you see they don't care. that's kind of the scene I was trying to set. But really, most of it is just talking that talk, you know.
What if you, Otis Clapp, I mean you, Lakai, but the raps that you had as Otis Clapp, or the raps that I have as YC the Setting, or even Kemba right now, went back to 1980. Well, people think, yo, this dude is nice, or we're like, yo, what the hell is this? What the hell is this?
Right over the
old. Like, what are you doing? What genre are you doing? This is
actually
not
just like this. I remember the time of day when I used to go out and I used to
play.
why graphics so fast?
People would think you're a robot. People would be like, you're a
robot. Imagine Eminem.
I feel like the crowd will be like,
Kimba.
Thank you.
Kimba. Kimba.
Why are you like this?
I remember, man, like, I definitely had no intention of, I just wanted to go support. It was around my neighborhood, you know what I'm saying? Like, so I just wanted to go and show love and support. I had no intention of getting arrested at all. But for me, what I wound up seeing was that, you know, like we were in this march, and then like cops just like lead us into this block where we couldn't even move. And then the sad part for me was like when they kettled us and kept us trapped in, they were like beating everybody, like
for real,
like elders, like there were kids in the middle of the march crying, like everybody was getting hit. Like it was, I never, like out of all the marches I've been in, I've never seen nothing like that before. Like, to the point where cops are breaking people's car windows, and they're like blaming it on us. Like, I'm like, bro, this is, and something that happened to me, like, cause you know, at the time, it was like the peak of the pandemic. Like, I had like the shield, I had the mask. A cop literally like took my shield and mask off and pepper sprayed the shit out of me. And I couldn't see for like 5 hours. Like, I was like blind, and then, next thing I know, I got punched by a cop, and then I'm on the ground, and then we were on our knees for like 3-4 hours in the middle of 136 in Brook. Like, bro, where?
Yeah, we were watching.
Yeah, like, I'm just like, yo, like, what? Like, they tell us where we was gonna go. We get to the precinct, we don't get no water, we don't get no phone calls.
Nah.
They, masks was considered a weapon, so nobody could wear a mask in a cell. We in a cell with like 30 people. No, like, I was just like, bro, like, this is, and it just shows that, like, even when the world's going through everything that it's going through right now, the cops like don't have any sympathy for that. You know, so that for me was like one of the craziest march experiences I've ever had, especially when I didn't even go there with the intention of getting rowdy like that. Like,
what does that mean, either rat?
Again, I was this close, searching up your addy on Obama, burn a flip phone, and riding through your zip code. Feet of black vans full of black masks, black man ammo fully quit flow. Pulling out a dolly like I'm Pitbull. Why do you get these working all hoods causing havoc? Grabbing it by the neck like you the Big Show. Swelling up my lymph nodes, we ain't get to fully rinse off the Flint water. This is Willie Lynch, daughter sons carrying that rich roll. I might die for this, living this. I might die for this. So I can't sit and watch y'all tripping, playing games with it. I might die for this shit, little nigga. I might die for this. So I can't sit and watch y'all tripping, playing games with it. If I die, just plant a tree and mix the ashes. I wanna help provide air for the masses. Free my soul of these inanimate attachments. I don't want no distractions when the empire crashes. I can't dwell whatever happened in the past tense. Because strange, like me, my nigga didn't want a patent. We got a first class ticket to pick a casket. Look at with the madness. Get them up to the back then. This is about to happen. I might die for this shit. I might die for this. So I can't sit and watch y'all just looking, playing games with it. I might die for this shit, little nigga. I might die for this. So I can't sit and watch y'all just looking, playing, get playing.
How long are we going to let this shit happen to us?